I have received several requests for a more detailed and slower tutorial on how to slipstream updates into an installation disk. We'll be slipstreaming the necessary updates to repair the Windows Update feature. To get started, open a browser and navigate to ntlite.com. Click on Download at the upper right of the page. Select the download that is appropriate for your system type. If you are not sure, you can check by right-clicking on the Start button and selecting System from the context menu. The system I'm using is 64-bit, so I will download the 64-bit version of NTLite. What we get is an executable file that we can run to launch the NTLite installer. Click the radio button to the left of I accept the agreement, then click Next. Pick the location where you want NTLite installed. My primary drive is an SSD, and I have a secondary drive that's mechanical. In an effort to conserve total bytes written, I want to install this on my secondary hard drive, so I will change C: to E: On this screen, we have a couple of options. I don't want a desktop shortcut, so I will deselect that. And I'm not interested in portable mode, so I will leave that blank and click Next. After a relatively short progress bar, we get the confirmation screen. I do highly recommend opening NTLite to verify that it's working and has no errors. Depending on your system configuration, you may get an error when NTLite attempts to launch. Leave the box checked for Launch NTLite and click Finish. If all went well, NTLite will be open. We can take the Windows Thin PC ISO and open it in a program like Power ISO, then extract the contents to a new folder on the desktop. Create another new folder and move the updates to that folder. Then create a third new folder for the drivers. Device drivers generally come in an installer package which can be opened like a compressed file using a program like 7-zip. We can extract the contents of the executable over to the drivers folder, so NTLite can access the drivers. We are now ready to open NTLite. If this is your first time using NTLite, click the Add button at the upper right of the screen and select Image Directory. Point to the folder on the desktop that contains the contents of the installation disk. We will now have an entry under Image History. Right-click the entry and select Load. NTLite will then mount the image so it can be modified. Allow several minutes for this process to complete. Now click Updates at the left of the screen. In this section, we can see what updates are already integrated with the image, and we can select new ones to integrate. Click the Add button at the upper left and select Directory Containing Packages and Add. Point to the folder on the desktop that contains the Windows updates. The left pane will fill with a list of updates. If everything looks correct, we can click Drivers at the left of the screen. Click Add at the top left of the screen and select Directory Containing Drivers, then Add. Point to the folder on the desktop with the drivers. The left pane will populate with a list of device drivers. The right-hand pane shows the devices on the PC where NTLite is open, and if the driver is present in the installation disk or not. For this project, I don't have a need to make further customizations to the installation disk. However, there are many more things you can do with NTLite. We can click Apply towards the lower left of the screen. Here we have a number of additional tasks that can be done. The image I'm working with only has one addition, so the remove and reapply options are not needed. I do want to mark Create ISO. Once you have selected the desired options, click the Process button at the top left. This process will take a very long time to complete. The request was for an uncut tutorial on how to slipstream updates, and this part requires no further interaction if you're using the full version of NTLite. Otherwise, there is a prompt where you can click OK to continue. So let's go through a little time warp here. Now we have a custom installation disk for Windows Thin PC.